U.S. State Department spokesperson said yesterday that the U.S. has taken note the pattern of ongoing PRC efforts to intimidate in the region, including in Taiwan, and the U.S. maintains the capability to resist resort to force in for people in on Taiwan to have any comments. The U.S. side falsely accuses China of intimidation and coercion, which have nothing to do with China. First, on the Taiwan question, who is actually guilty of intimidation and coercion? There is only one China in the world, and the Taiwan region is an inalienable part of China's territory. The government of the PRC is the sole legal government representing all of China. This is a basic fact recognized by all. The One China principle is the political foundation of China-U.S. relations and a clear commitment in the three joint communiques, a red line that cannot be crossed.
Many
U.S. warships have frequently sailed to the Taiwan Straits to flex muscles, provoke and stir up trouble, sending gravely wrong signals to Taiwan independence forces and threatening peace and stability across the region. I'd like to ask, have Chinese warships gone to the Gulf of Mexico to flex muscles? Second, who is guilty of intimidation and coercion across the globe? When has the U.S. stopped at mere intimidation and coercion? It has fought no war for only 16 of its 250 years of history. It operates over 806 military bases over the world. Its military spending ranked top in the world for many years, accounting for 40% of the global total. A report shows that U.S. has launched 228 military interventions, including wars, during the 3 decades since the Cold War ended.
当年, 美国,
citing
一瓶洗衣粉,
a tube of laundry powder and a staged video as evidence,
证据, 就对伊拉克和叙利亚,
the U.S. struck Iraq and Syria, both sovereign nations,
平民伤亡,
causing massive civilian casualties
破散,
and wrecking numerous
homes.
U.S. also wantonly wields sanctions as a big stick and arbitrarily imposes illegal unilateral sanctions on other sovereign states. A U.S. senior official once said, we make mistakes, but we confront challenges, not try to ignore them. So what U.S. should do first is apologize to the people of Iraq and Syria and assume responsibility. I ask, if it fails in doing so, how can the U.S. claim it always confronts challenges instead of trying to ignore them? I stress again, China has no intention to intimidate or coerce anyone, but we have no fear for intimidation or coercion, wherever it may come from. China won't be lacking in either will or capacity to defend its sovereignty and territorial integrity.
The
U.S. should fully grasp the high sensitive nature of the Taiwan question, abiding by the One China principle, the three China-U.S. joint communiques, avoid the dangerous path of challenging the bottom line and playing with fire, prudently and properly handling Taiwan-related issues, refrain from sending any wrong signals to Taiwan independence forces, to prevent serious damage to its own interests and peace and stability across Taiwan Strait.
下一个问题。